Chapter 3, Section 2. But what about so-called anarcho-capitalist support for charity? Yes. While being blind to the impact of inequality in terms of economic and social power and influence, most right libertarians do argue that the very poor could depend on charity in their system. But such a recognition of poverty does not reflect an awareness of the need for equality or the impact of inequality on the agreements we make. Quite the reverse, in fact, as the existence of extensive inequality is assumed. After all, in a society of relative equals, poverty would not exist, nor would charity be needed. Ignoring the fact that their ideology hardly promotes a charitable perspective, let's raise 4 points. Firstly, charity will not be enough to countermand the existence and impact of vast inequalities of wealth and so power. Secondly, it will be likely that charities will be concerned with improving the moral quality of the poor, and so will divide them into the deserving, i.e. obedient, and undeserving, i.e. rebellious poor. Charity will be forthcoming to the former, those who agree to busybodies sticking their noses into their lives. In this way, charity could become another tool of economic and social power. See Oscar Wilde's The Soul of Man Under Socialism for more on charity. Thirdly, it's unlikely that charity will be able to replace all the social spending conducted by the state. To do so would require a tenfold increase in charitable donations, and given that most right libertarians denounce the government for making them pay taxes to help the poor, it seems unlikely that they will turn around and increase the amount they give. And lastly, charity is an implicit recognition that under capitalism, no one has the right to life. It's a privilege you pay for. That in and itself is enough to reject the charity option. And of course, in a system designed to secure the life and liberty of each person, how can it be deemed acceptable to leave the life and protection of even one individual to the charitable whims of another? Perhaps it will be argued that individuals have the right to life, but not a right to be a parasite. This ignores the fact that some people cannot work, babies and handicapped people, that in a functioning capitalist economy, many people cannot find work at all times. It is this recognition of that babies cannot work that prompts many right libertarians to turn them into property. Of course, rich folk who have never done a day's work in their lives are never classified as parasites either, even if they did inherit all their money. All things considered, little wonder that Proudhon argued that even charitable institutions serve the ends of those in authority marvelously well. Charity is the strongest chain by which privilege and the government, bound to protect them, holds down the lower classes. With charity, sweeter to the heart of men, more intelligible to the poor man than the abstruse laws of political economy, one may dispense with justice. The idea of the revolution. The general idea of the revolution, page 69 to 70. As noted, the right libertarian passing acknowledgement of poverty does not mean that they recognize the existence of market power. They never ask them.